for you on what is fatigue and what's the reasons for fatigue and what can you do about it. So there's many, many reasons for fatigue, because you need to understand what fatigue is. Once the body is in out of order, out of balance, the number one sign is that you get tired. So depending on the intensity and, of your fatigue or your tiredness, there are different reasons for that. Now let me just go through a few of them so you understand. One of the first reasons for fatigue is your body is dehydrated. Our body is meant to have about 60 to 70% water, and if you don't have that amount of water in your body, first sign is fatigue, then injuries and headaches and stuff like that. It all comes in a whole nine yard. And second is magnesium deficiency. Magnesium is the first mineral which basically used in our energy making cycle. So if you don't have enough of in your body because you are too stressed, that means depleting lots of magnesium out of your body, then obviously are you going to be tired. So you need to be putting this into your body on from a supplement source. Another reason is how you eat. So the way how you eat determines how you feel and how is your energy level and how fatigued are you. If your blood sugar level constantly dropping up and down, that will mean that you constantly will be tired as your blood sugar level is dropping down. And look at videos on how to eat alive and balancing your meals out in a way that your energy level stays stable, so you're therefore your fatigue basically disappears. Now one of another major reason is sleep and the time of your sleep. So if you timing your sleep and it's mostly shifted to very, very late night and mornings and middays, it affects a lot on how you are going to feel during the day. We meant to sleep at night when there is dark, and because our physical recovery is happening between 12 p.m. to 2 a.m. and our psychological recovery and our immune system recovery happens between 2 a.m. to 6 a.m. So basically, if you are on a night shift, you can change this actually around and sleep in the afternoon, or if you sleep in the morning, it has to be in a completely dark room. But however, the fluctuation of the times when you are going to sleep, and if it's not even, that means it's uneven. Sometimes you go to bed this time, sometimes that time, that will affect how you sleep, how you feel, because your body just cannot get into the tone of in a mood of getting you into an organized schedule and to recover you and get used to this schedule. So these are very important factors. There are many other things in the body, and one of the things I like to call attention is basically the full moon. The full moon starts to trigger some magnetic changes and forces in our body, and which is shown into the tides, right? As if the water comes out and goes back in the waves. It works the same way in our body. It triggers actually this magnetic field or energy field, triggers the parasites, bacteria and fungus to multiply in our body. So every 4 weeks they will be multiplying. These will be multiplying in our guts, and the byproducts of these bacteria and funguses like candida, they produce stuff which is actually poison for our body. This can also give us, especially candida, great amount of fatigue, so as migraines. So these were just a very few things what you can do about to look into your hydration, how you eat, taking enough magnesium, and balancing your meals, and looking into if these fatigues are coming on a regular basis, then you can get in touch with a healthcare professional to sort all this out. So these are the things that you can do, and if there is anything else, you can just contact me.